Alright, so in this video, we're going to graph some lines, okay? I want you to call number 1. We've already done this, if you think back. I want to make this connection here. This number 1, example number 1, is a problem from B6. Okay, we did graph lines a couple chapters ago in this what we call standard form, x, y on the same side, okay? And now we're going to deal with these guys in this chapter. A lot of them are going to be in what's called slope-intercept form, which we talked about in the last couple chapters, okay? So first, let's do the one more as a review. Remember, we're doing these two different ways. If it's in this standard form, where x and y on the same side, we did it by these intercepts. Remember this? So we're going to do that again here. If x is 0, what's y? If y is 0, what's x? Okay, so let's go through this. 4 times 0 minus y equals 4. So that goes away, and I'm left with negative y equals 4. If you want, you can put a 1 there, just to remind you or to help you to know what to divide by. Divide by negative 1, right? And that gives me y equals negative 4. And then we do the whole thing again for x. So for x, that is, I put a 0 in for the y. 4x minus 0 equals 4. That goes away. I get 4x equals 4, so I divide by 4, and x equals 4 divided by 4 is 1. Did that pretty quickly, because we've done it before. Hopefully you remember. I plot these two points, right? You'll notice I'm not finding the slope. We're going to do that in the remaining problems. Okay, so 0, negative 4 is down here. 1, 0 is right here. All right, and there's my two points. And then I draw a line through those two points. Remember that? And my line looks something like that. Okay? Alright, so now let's take a look at this next problem. This one we're going to do a different way. Okay, what we learned in the last couple chapters is that this is y equals mx plus b. You'll notice it's in this form, right? Where y is all by itself. You got a number times x, and then a number at the end. Okay, so you'll notice if I can just pick these out, the m is negative 1/2, right? That's the number times the x. And the b, you can see right here, is negative 3. So write that down if you want. The slope's negative 1/2. The intercept, the b value, is negative 3. That's all I need to graph this line. Okay, so the y-intercept is negative 3. Label my intercepts here. Or my axes, that is. Y-intercept's negative 3. That means I start right here. Okay, so I know that's one point. That's like a free point, right? Remember, b equals negative 3. That means this point is on the graph. 0, comma, negative 3. That means I always start on my y-axis for lines in this form. And then I use the slope to get to my next point. Okay? Remember, that's rise over run. So that means I go over 2. Notice how I signed the negative with the top. I'm always going to do that if it's negative. I'm going to sign it to the numerator. So that means I go over 2 and I go down 1 from this intercept. So I start here, I go over 2, down 1, and I get my second point. Different method, still a line though. Okay? And I draw my line through those two points. And that's it. Okay, let's try another one. Alright, example 3. Graph the following line, y equals 2x plus 1. Okay, again, I can identify that my slope is 2. I'm going to make it a fraction, okay, and that my b value, my y-intercept, is 1, just looking at the equation. So I start here, and I use the slope to get my next point. Everything's positive here, that means I go over 1 and up 2 to get to my next point, right? Over 1, up 2. And there's my next point. Draw a line through these two points. And you got your line. Okay? It's not too bad, right? So I'm going to stop this video here and pick up with example 4 in the next video.